close to my heart, the Women and Veterans Bill. When we talk about veterans, and y'all know, when we talk about veterans, first thing comes to our mind is males. We don't talk about the female veterans who have children, some divorced, and single parents. What we co-opting is form partnership with state, local government, create. Well, first they ask me, well, how are you gonna pay for this stuff, Mike? We take this bill right here, and we get special tags for a female veteran, women veteran. And with the proceeds from those tags that's coming in, those going to pay for this bill. So it's not gonna be open empty legislation with no money, or we're just gonna push it out. No. I was in Atlanta a couple weeks ago, and I was talking to Landon. Landon has started a small business. He came back here after he played his career with the Seattle Seahawks. And Landon is 27 years old. And I said, man, I said, congratulations, man. I said, you created about 12 jobs downtown in Spartanburg. And he said, no, Mr. Mike, I created 28 jobs in this community, downtown Spartanburg. I said, really? I also met with Joe and Kim, who own Hub City Delivery. Those two young people left their corporate jobs and started this business. They created 35 jobs. Good paying jobs. Here's what I'm saying. Those young people need to be duplicated. We need to take other young folks. I was just walking in the library for business, and I saw the young people just hanging out. They should be somewhere in front of a computer, learning the skill, how to start their own business. Those opportunities are not there yet. This is what my plan is. We got to engage our former delegation, our city council, and our county council. We got to engage in local businesses. As hard as it is, I know Brandon squirm when we say that, but we got to deal with the Walmarts of the world to help our young people, because they're here. They're part of our community, folks. I know Brandon reasons. I tell you, Brandon. Now Brandon is one of my real true heroes in this community, and I'll tell you about it later. But it's simple. We take young people, we train them up, we put them in position to succeed. Okay, then everybody's not going to college. So once they get the training, first of all, find their passion, their idea of what they want to do. And with Eric and John and the rest of the team, bring them in the room, we sit them down and formulate their plan. It's a win-win for everybody. It's a tax base created. We have these empty buildings in the District 31, but they be filled because they're just sitting there. We talk with the landlords, the owner of these properties, and let's work out a deal. We have outlets, Mr. Myers and radio program, who get the message out to these young folks. We've got to be able to be vocal, speak louder. And be, thank you, sir. And be conscientious about, I hear babies cry. Be conscientious about this district. My opponent, who has been in Columbia for the past 10 years, my opponent has very little or any legislation that he pushed through since he's been there. I supported him his first term, his second term. After I looked around, like, this guy's not doing anything. He's just like all the other guys. He goes out there. So the opportunity for me, for us, to create meaningful legislation, we got to be engaged with one another. Here's the pass for the bill. And I won't insult anybody.
So many have been lost, and so many can be found, if you just fight with me. Support my campaign, Fix 31.